Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica, and today I'm doing another 4x4, this time for Colourpop Cosmetics. If you missed my previous 4x4, I'll go ahead and throw that up in the cards for you to check out, but this is basically my series where I go through the top 4 best items from a brand and the top 4 worst. So before we jump in, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you like this series. And if you haven't already and you would like to, I hope you consider subscribing, hitting the little bell icon so you're notified whenever I post a new video every Monday through Friday. All right, so let me just pull up my notes real quick. We're gonna get into ColourPop. Like my last video, we're gonna switch between good and bad products, every other product. And I'm currently traveling, so I don't actually have the products that I like with me, even though I do own all of them. So I'm gonna like scooch over, scooch. And then we're gonna throw up some really cute pictures, kind of like a weekly wow, but not really. So the first product that I wanna talk to, one of the best products that ColourPop has, the Yes Please palette. This palette was phenomenal and it could not have been timed better. This came out at the height of the Natasha Denona sunset palette craze, and at first nobody could really believe it. It was the first palette ColourPop had ever come out with. They'd only been doing singles and Super Shock, so this was their first palette. So people were a little bit skeptical, myself included at first. But for the price point, you're paying $16 for this palette, for the shades and how it's not an exact dupe of the Natasha Denona palette, but it's close, and the color story is close enough that you get the feel for it. And just the shadows are gorgeous in this palette. They're creamy, they're buttery. You seriously, if you have this palette, you don't really need another warm toned palette because you really have everything right there. I will say the pans are a little bit smaller than you might expect. They're just a little bit bigger than a dime. So they are a little small, but you do get a lot of product. They're not the fastest formula to pan. They are a little bit harder pressed. So I've had mine for a while. I've used it. I have not hit pan in any shades, but I have not tried panning a ColourPop palette, so I'm not quite sure like the amount of time it would actually take to hit pan. But for that price, you're getting a good amount of product. Like I said, this was the eyeshadow palette heard around the world. Everyone lost their minds when this came out, and for good reason. So if you have not tried out this palette and you're interested and you're just a little bit on the fence, try it. You won't be sorry. Something I wish I could have gone back in time and stopped myself from trying. I'm being mean, but this is the foundation. They're No Filter Foundation. This, it's really affordable. They've got a good shade range. Did not work well on my skin. I have a whole video on my experience with the entire No Filter complexion line. I'll throw that up in the cards for you to check out. But this was one of the worst foundations, not even just like worst drugstore priced foundations, one of the worst foundations that I've ever tried. I don't want to repeat myself too much from that ColourPop video, but it just did not hold up well throughout the day. It aged me terribly. The shade, it did not match, and I bought two shades. It just, there was not one thing that I liked about this foundation, which is rare. Normally I find one thing that I'm like, okay, well at least it has this, so I could try to mix it. Or, you know, it has all these things, but hey, at least this part is good. There was not one thing about this foundation that I actually liked. I've seen so many videos, so many reviews on this foundation, and it's worked so well for so many people, and I'm really happy for them. And that's another thing just about makeup. It's just so personal, and just, it works different for everybody. So of course you're gonna try to find someone who has like a skin type closer to you, or, you know, try it out yourself. But for me, it was just one of the worst foundations ever. The next awesome product from ColourPop is one of their lip lines. These are their Ultra Satin Lips. These are among the most comfortable lip products I've ever tried. I have an entire collection of ColourPop lips. I'll throw a picture up here. I have a lot of them. I have a lot. My favorite is the Ultra Satin Lip. It is not transfer proof, so it will get on glasses. You will have to reapply. But I would trade that off for how comfortable and pigmented these are. Like, it's not a bad thing for me, because we'll get into their ultra matte lips later, but it's not a bad thing. It's a pretty good trade off for how great they look, how many colors they come in, how comfortable they are. It's just, they're overall really great. They're really affordable. I mean, everything, we're gonna just put in the lower line that everything from Colourpop is affordable, so that's gonna be a pro for pretty much everything. But just to find a really great liquid lip that is really affordable, and the thing is, if you really want to try different colors, get out of your comfort zone, that's a great place to start. Like, I had never really worn lipstick that much before I tried out the Colourpop lips, and since they were so affordable, I was able to pick out a few colors, try different things on, actually get used to seeing myself in like a dark, like mauve lip, or in like a brown lip. And I think that's such a great place to start if you're just exploring lip colors. It's a comfortable formula, they got a lot of shades, they wear pretty well. Like, you have to reapply once or twice depending on what you're doing. But I think that they're definitely something great to try out, and one of their best product lines, like that Colourpop has. If you saw the complexion video, you kind of know where these negative products are gonna go. But the next product is the concealer. I really wanted this one to work out. Nothing I did made this concealer work. It was way too dry, way too crepey, and it darkened. I got two shades. I think I had the shade 10 and shade 16. They were both, well, 10 looked way too light when I first applied it and then darkened down to something that was just a little bit too light. And then shade 16 was like my perfect shade, but then darkened down like raccoon eyes if I wore it under my eyes. And if I spot concealed, you would just be like a spot right here that was darker than everywhere else. And it would just be like, hey, look, there's a pimple there. Why don't you look at it? You should. We've circled it for you right there. The formula just was not a good match for me. I will say I'm a bit picky when it comes to concealer formulas. I do have a video all about really good affordable concealers that work really well for me. I'll throw that up in the cards. It took a lot of searching, a lot of testing to actually find those. And unfortunately, just the Colourpop concealer was a speed bump on the way to finding stuff that actually worked. The next really good product line from Colourpop are their bullet lipsticks. So these also come in a great variety of shades. I have plenty of these, but I will admit, like, even though I have quite a few of these, I've only worn a couple of them. It's partly just me not reaching for traditional bullet lipsticks as much as I reach for liquid lipsticks. But it's also just me forgetting that, like, I have them, which is, it sounds really bad. But in my collection, things can get lost fairly easily, and that combined with the fact that I'm not reaching for bullet lipsticks means that I kind of have these on display and I'm not really reaching for them, but I need to because they're a great formula. They come in a huge range of shades, and you're not just getting your traditional shades. They have a black one, which I actually really like. They have bright colors, they have deep colors, they have your neutrals, they've got beautiful reds. And they're really affordable for a good bullet lipstick. That if you're looking for a good bullet lipstick, again, like with the Ultra Satin lips, if you wanna try out different colors, if you're looking for like a collection starter, cause like this is something you can pick up a couple of them cause they're only like $6-$7 each, which is really affordable. You gotta put that out there. They are a really comfortable formula. They do dry down like a little bit, but they're not like completely matte, but they're not completely satin. They do dry down a little bit. I do see if I wear the darker colors, like a little bit of a line down here, but for me, if I'm wearing a bullet lipstick, it's like I know this isn't gonna last very long and I'm gonna be reapplying it, so I already have that mindset. So it's gonna be like in my purse and I'm gonna be touching up, I'm gonna have a little mirror. So just keeping that in mind, it's not going to be as bulletproof as a liquid lipstick, but they're still going to look beautiful, be comfortable, and really be just such a great affordable staple in your collection. Again, if you watched my Colourpop video, you know where this one's going. We're gonna talk about their loose powder. I didn't like it. The shade was not, I picked up the shade translucent. It was not translucent. I feel like they didn't come out with as many shades as they should have if they were going to make their translucent powder white, which it was way too bright for under my eyes. It's great if you have a lighter complexion and you have trouble finding a powder, great, that's for you. I could not get it to work, and then the next darker shade, I couldn't make it work. I tried using this just anywhere, and then even like ignoring the shade, just the way that it wore aged me terribly. And I didn't just use this with the ColourPop concealer, I used this with other concealers. No matter what I used it with, you would see a reverse raccoon line where it ended into where it wasn't sitting well on top of the foundation versus on top of the concealer. It got deep into like my fine lines, which, oh my god, like if you ever want to like feel really bad about your fine lines, use that powder, because you'll see every single one of them. And you also see ones that didn't exist, like they don't exist, but they make them. It didn't look good when baking, it didn't look good when I just used a little bit to set. I just could not make it work. And also, it's a really small container that you get. It's not a whole lot of product. That's also running theme among their complexion products, is like, oh, they're really affordable and they're really great and look at this. But the pressed powder only had like half the amount of product as a normal compact from the drugstore, and so you go through it really fast. The loose powder only had half the amount of product, and so you go through that. They did pretty well in the rest of their products, their lipsticks, their eyeshadows. Why did they skimp when it came to their complexion products? Okay, so the last best product from ColourPop is going to be their Super Shock Shadows. And yes, I did have to just say that line like three times because I kept messing up Super Shock Shadow. Super Shock Shadow. I think people fall into the pit of buying a whole bunch of these at once, which isn't a great idea because they're such a unique formula and they can dry out so fast that you'll never go through a whole one if you have a whole collection to work with. Like I've seen YouTubers where they have like every shade. You're not even gonna try it once before it dries out. And even though like if you screw the cap on really tight and you keep them really protected, eventually they're gonna dry out. They don't last that long. I've had one, especially the mattes. I wouldn't really recommend the mattes. The shimmers are more what I'm recommending here, because the mattes, even if you do use them, and even if you keep them tightly, you know, closed, max I've gotten a year out of those, and they just dry up to crumbles and you can't bring them back. You just can't. So I really, really suggest just keeping one or two shades that you like really, really are into and like, and just have those in that formula, because it is such a unique formula. My absolute favorite shade of all time is Sailor. I'll throw a picture up here. It looks a little bit boring, but it's like this neutral like beige shade that has little sparkles of blue and green in it, and it looks gorgeous on the eye, and I just, it's one of those shades where you could just put it all over the lid and then you don't really need anything else and you've got a gorgeous look. Just blend out like a little transition color and then you're good, and you'll get compliments. It reflects in the light so pretty. God, I could wax poetic about that Sailor shade for a good long time, but to save you all of that, just try out one or two of these Super Shock Shadows and don't collect a whole bunch. I currently have like 8 or 9 and that's too much. Like I know I'm not gonna use all those before they dry out, but I fell into the pit of like, oh, they're so affordable and I wanna try them all. But really, you're not gonna use a whole one most likely before it dries out. So just try one or two that look great and look interesting to you, because it's such a good formula. And I think that's what they base their brand off of, if I'm not mistaken. I think that's one of their first products for good reason. There's a reason ColourPop blew up originally, and you know, they do some things really well. This is one of them. The worst product line from ColourPop, surprisingly not their complexion line like everyone I know thought it would be, but it's their Ultra Matte Lips. Their Ultra Matte Lipsticks are the most drying, the cakiest looking, the most uncomfortable lipsticks ever. It's one thing if a lipstick is uncomfortable but looks good throughout the day, Kylie. It's another thing if it's really uncomfortable and like you feel the lipstick flaking off and you're embarrassed and then it doesn't even look good. Even if you put on like a balm underneath it, I've even tried these with glosses on top and it gets like goopy with the gloss, and I just can't make these work. And I bought a decent amount of them because everyone was like raving about them when they first came out. They're just too matte. they're really pigmented. I will say, if you're only wearing them for like a picture, or if you're only gonna put it on for less than half an hour and then take it off, yeah, they're pretty good. They look cute. If you're looking for anything longer than 30 minutes and you don't wanna be in constant discomfort, just like, then don't, just don't. Okay, and that is everything for this ColourPop 4x4. Let me know down below what you think the best and worst product from ColourPop is, and I hope I'll see you in my next video. Bye.